Die Hinweise verdichten sich, Leute. Es gibt ein geheimes Labor in Tel Aviv, wo an E-Mobilität geforscht wird. Das interessiert uns natürlich ganz besonders. Und zwar die Renault-Nissan-Mitsubishi Alliance hat hier im WeWorks Center in Tel Aviv einen Open Innovation Lab gegründet. Und wir haben einen Termin. Wir werden euch zeigen, was da alles passiert. Seid gespannt. Viel Spaß. So, also wir sind angekommen, wir sind endlich hier im Coworking Space WeWork in Tel Aviv und wir sind hier bei der Renault-Nissan-Mitsubishi Alliance, great, und wir sprechen mit Antoine Basseville, er leitet dieses Büro hier und er wird uns einige Fragen beantworten, was dieses Ding hier eigentlich soll, an was hier geforscht wird und warum dieses Unternehmen, dieses Labor von Renault hier in Tel Aviv eigentlich so wichtig ist. Monsieur Basseville, thank you for having us here. It's a great pleasure to see all the things that are going on here in Tel Aviv. At the beginning, we wanted to make an interview with Renault here, but actually it's a whole alliance containing 11 brands, right?
10 brands.
10 brands?
Yeah, Shalom guys, okay, from all over the world. Yes, we are here for three main groups, mm-hmm. The Renault groups, the Nissan groups, and the Mitsubishi groups. So it means 10 million car a year, but it means also 10 brands. And we'll try to find the right one. No, it's too long. Renault, Dacia, okay. Alpine, Samsung, Lada, Nissan, Mitsubishi, Venuccia, Datsun, yeah. And Mitsubishi. I think I got it. So we are working at the alliance level. Yeah. And we are working on three pillars, let's say, that are connected to our needs for the alliance. The first one here is cybersecurity, because we have to take care of these kind of things. It's a new danger, let's say, for the automotive industry. Second one is sensor for ADAS, because when you want to drive a car, now you want not to drive the car, okay? And so you need sensors to be able to view instead of you seeing things, and so then to pilot the car the right way. And third thing is about data and smart city, because here also we are working with the importer and also with the smart city center of Tel Aviv City. And so we are trying to mix everything on those kind of subjects and then to deliver to those three corporates, to those 10 brands, new things, innovation that could be applied on the component side, let's say on the car, but also on the services. Yes, for sure, the customer is looking for this kind of protection, let's say, of their car. They are honestly not ready to pay. I'm pretty sure that when you are using your computer, yeah. You are adding something to protect your computer, you are not paying for it. And so it's the same story for the automotive industry. Customers want to be protected, for sure. A car is not just a way to move, it's also moving but being protected. Okay. Yeah, yeah. And so we need to go in this direction. For sure, also, Israel is at the highest level and has very good solution everywhere, okay? Yeah. And so we are trying to see what could be applied from, let's say, the military areas, the country areas, to the car, to try to protect our cars, to protect also the communication between the car and the server, the cloud, because it's not only data that are inside the car. You want also to protect your data from, let's say, big companies, okay? And so we have to protect that, and also the server, because when we are going to share cars, and it's a trend, okay, for sure, so cars are shared. And so if you can take a car that is not booked for you, it could be also tricky, yeah. For you, but also for us. And so, yes, for sure, we are working a lot on those perimeters with people from the corporate also, for sure. Mm-hmm. And it's a subject we need to work on, but for sure also, people are too afraid, so we cannot say so much things, but yes, for sure, it's a pillar that we need to do deep dive and to find solution here.
Yes. Also Leute, Sicherheit ist ein Riesenthema. Super Sache hier, die auch wirklich wichtig ist und die allen Marken dieser Dachorganisation Renault-Nissan Alliance zugutekommt. Jetzt werden wir etwas über die Kamerasysteme sprechen, die hier entwickelt werden. The cameras and the sensors in the car, in the self-driving car, they have to be developed here. You make also cameras here, right?
So here we are there to find the right technologies through startup and universities and to test it and to put it on our cars to be sure that it's really efficient and it's also in accordance with our needs. Okay. Because needs from one brand could be also a little bit different from the other. And for those cameras, if we are going to the customer level, if we are all thinking of autonomous cars, we want to be to have a car that is completely autonomous. So it means you want to see not only the car that is going and you can have a look, you want to see also the ones that are behind. Okay? And so that means that those sensors are not just at the same level than our capacity as human, but are more efficient than human. And for that, it means that we need not only cameras, but also radar, LiDAR, and so on, that can see, let's say, behind the wall, behind the other car, behind, I don't know, another street and so on.
If the car in front of the car, in front of the car of my car will break, the system recognizes it and takes steps.
And so there are two ways to do that. It's what we call V2X, V2V. So it means communication between cars. Okay, so then when someone is braking its car, you will have the information going to the next car, next car, and so on. Okay. But also you need to be able to do it alone, also to predict that another car is coming, even if it's not connected, because all the car will not be suddenly connected each other. And so the sensor also for that, and also to know exactly where are you on the road, are you on the right line, on the left line, and so on.
You said connection between cars. This is a system Renault and Nissan and the other 10 or 8 brands are working on. What about the other cars? Is there any co-working between the other brands and Renault, Nissan and the other brands of your alliance to establish one system which will work for the whole traffic?
Yes, for sure. We cannot have on each company one solution that is not compatible with the other companies. So for sure, the relation will be step by step common, and the tools, let's say the algorithm and the software and so on, will be probably common, or at least in the information that are delivered from one car to the other, it has to be standardized. So for sure, we are going on this direction. But whatever, it's not today, it's not available. So we are also learning how to do that, how to be efficient, how also not to be too cost expensive. Because also going back to the customer, everybody wants to have a safe car, autonomous car, but you don't want to pay for most of those features. So we have to find the right balance between the cost, the solution, technical solution, and what is the value for the customer.
Good point. You're developing solutions which will be affordable for many people.
That's also the story of those 10 brands. If you are having a look at Alpine or Infiniti, for instance, probably the customer will be ready to test new technologies also. They will be more geek, probably on the Infiniti side, for instance, than on Dacia side, okay, or Datsun side. And so also we have to find solutions that could be compatible with those various customers.
So we found your company here in Tel Aviv. Why Tel Aviv?
Why Tel Aviv? Because why first Israel? For sure, all those technologies are there. And if we are trying to compare what is made in Silicon Valley, for instance, that is really famous for innovation, and what is done here, the country here is more on the technical side. Silicon Valley is more about the business model. Here it's more about the technical side. So to be there, it's really where new technologies are coming. So it's the context with those people working here, with very high-level people, but also the name of Tel Aviv that is also important for us.
We also talked about electric cars, and you are able to work here in Israel with two startups at this scene?
Yes, so we already are working with various startups, but the two that are already published, let's say, and that we can share with you are two startups. One is the company that is is charging the car while driving. The subject is about mainly bus. It's a way to reduce the size of batteries and also the range, because you will not have any more problem of range. Okay, so that's the first subject we are working on, and we provide them a car to test everything and then to see if it could be applied or not. The second one is more about the controller for electrical engine. You know that the main question for the customer is the range of our electric cars. Now it's increasing step by step, 300, 400 kilometers with a Zoe, for instance, or with a Leaf. But whatever, for a few cases, it's not enough. And so if we can increase the efficiency of the engine, for sure everybody will enjoy it. And so we are working with a company that is making a very specific controller for those engines, increasing, let's say, the efficiency of this engine. And so you can increase the power, increase the torque, or increase the range, or balance between those various components. And so it means for the customer, I don't know, 500-600 kilometers without any needs to charge a car. And I think we are all looking for that, and it will be a real pleasure to be able to have those smooth and quiet cars everywhere.
we already saw that much electric vehicles in Tel Aviv, but not that much electric cars, but e-bikes and e-scooters and stuff like that. What about electric cars on the streets of Tel Aviv?
Today there are not so many cars here that are EVs, for sure. The biggest fleet, let's say, is in Haifa, in the north of Tel Aviv. It's a fleet of 130, 50 Zoe that are operated by the city of Haifa. And we are one of the companies that has helping this company to operate and to try to find the new trends and new features and so on. But you're right, not so many cars are here electric. Today, as the customer is more looking at the cost of the car and not only at the, and not taking into account so much the energy, what we call total cost of ownership, yeah. The customer is not feeling that the electric vehicles are cheaper, in fact, than regular cars. And so we have also to teach and to find the right way also to communicate about that, also to sell the car. And
it's our problem in Europe too, yeah? Yeah. Because they are looking at the price of the car, and not looking at the cost of the monthly cost of the car, and it is in fact equal or cheaper, yeah. But the people don't realize it or recognize it.
Yeah, yes, for sure. Is that the problem of the cost, let's say, of the price for the customer? But also, you need to drive an electric vehicle.
Okay.
Let's drive a car. Let's take a car. Let's try to find an EV car and drive it. It's pleasure. It's pure pleasure. It's not only cost, it's pleasure. Yeah. Why? Because it's quiet, but also it's really with high level of acceleration. There is a very famous brand with on this cup, but whatever. Even trying a Zoe, even trying a Leaf, all those cars are really nice, very good acceleration, quiet, and so on. And when you need to fill the car, you go home and you plug the car on the classical outlet if you don't need too much power. And for me, those dimensions are not already in the mindset of a lot of people. And so they are not able to really understand all this scope that is for sure different from the usual scope we are looking at. And I'm pretty sure that step by step, people will try those EVs and they enjoy it, and then you cannot go back to classical engine, I think. Yeah. When you are trying an EV, I don't know about you, but it's so different, such a pleasure.
Yeah, I drive an EV, I will never go back to a gasoline car, yeah.
Exactly. And for sure, whatever, the cost, the price for the customer is still there, but the cost will be reduced also, and then there will be only pleasure. And so I'm pretty sure that a lot of people will switch to classical engine, to electrical engine.
So you should go on the streets and let the people try your cars, right?
I have a Twizy here, and I have a Twizy, but also a lot of friends. When I'm driving the Twizy here, everybody, each day, I have, I don't know, something like 3 to 5 people at least saying, what is it? Maze means what is it? Okay, in Hebrew. And what is it? And so I'm trying to explain it's electric, fully electric, without any window. So it's strange for those people here because, you know, during summer it's really hot here. But whatever, all those people are saying, yes, it's great, it's beautiful, Mazal Tov, and so on. So, yeah, Mazal Tov, yes. And so, yes, I'm pretty sure that step by step, this country, like the other one, will go to the electrical vehicle. And also here, you have so many sun. So if you want to charge a battery with solar components, okay, you can do it easily. And so it's also something that is going on. I can say more than that, but if you have a look at the various startup here, you will see also startup working on this kind of subject, and so for sure that are interesting.
Cool. Great place here. Great work you and your team is accomplishing. Thanks for having us here, and all the best for your future personally. I think you enjoyed working in Tel Aviv until now, and also all the best for the Alliance. For the electrical future, yeah, right?
Thanks a lot, and shalom to your customers.
Shalom. Shalom, boys and girls.
Ja Leute, das war's mit unserem Interview hier im Open Innovation Lab von Renault Nissan Mitsubishi, von dieser Allianz hier in Tel Aviv. Super Beitrag, wie ich finde, hat echt Spaß gemacht, hier mal zu sehen, was alles Tolles passiert. Ja, und euch lieben Dank fürs Dabeisein wieder mal bei Icario. Danke fürs Abonnieren des Kanals natürlich. Wenn euch das Video gefallen hat, liked es bitte. Schreibt auch eure Meinung unten drunter, was euch besonders gefallen hat oder wie ihr dieses Thema seht. Ja, und bis zum nächsten Mal bei Icario. Go green, mit Style.